Hello and welcome to my InDesign Flatplan. I'm delighted to present this product to you that will hopefully ease the planning of your editorial design projects in the future. You can choose between a text-based or an image-based flatplan. Of course, you can use both. First, I will show you the text-based version. I open the document in InDesign, and as you can see from the file extension, this is a template file. If I open that in InDesign, you'll get a document that is still unnamed. You can see that in the header, and also the date of saving can be seen here. Showing the layers, I move the canvas a bit upwards. Then you'll see that the date is set dynamically as well as the document title. I'm saving this document with the name magazine. Activate and deactivate the preview with the keyboard shortcut W. And as you see, the title has been inherited from the document title. Now I hide the descriptive layer again. A second layer shows the markers for the print production. I show and hide it right here. The colorful lines correspond to a correct number of pages necessary for a print production, which, as you probably know, has to be divisible by 4. In case you find yourself in between those markers, you know you still have to add pages until the next line. I hide the layer panel again. And I also deactivate the preview, and now we can see how this document is set up. There are text boxes, and in those text boxes there are smaller text boxes that contain tables. This setup makes it possible to move the pages around the document individually. I select, for instance, the content of this table cell, color it, as well as the content here, and this will make it easier to see the movement of the pages. If I set the cursor right here in this space and additionally mark the second text box, which is an anchored object, I can now, if I click into this empty space and keep the mouse button pressed down, move this spread to any location within the document. As you can see, the page numbers get adjusted automatically, and this way you can easily adapt your layouts. If you're not able to move your pages, you have to check your InDesign preferences for a special option that is probably deactivated. I hit Command K on a Mac or Control K on a PC, and in the section for input, the box Activate in Layout View should be checked to move text via dragging and placing. Another possibility to adjust the flat plan would be to place an advertisement. I mark this with a blue background. I'm zooming in to increase the visibility. If you have to place the ad on page 10 instead of page 11, then again activate the text tool. The indicator for marking a table already shows up. Select the right page and the cursor indicates that you can now move those table cells. This will only work if you have InDesign Creative Cloud 2014 or higher installed. If you click and drag, you will be able to move the right page to the left and the ad is updated. The documents are typeset in Arial by default, so they will work on any computer system. You can adjust the font to your personal preference. I defined several paragraph styles, and there are different styles for different things. All those styles are based on this base paragraph style. If you wish, you can also edit those styles individually. It should be sufficient, though, to only edit the base style. I open the paragraph style options dialog and change the font family to Minion. I activate the preview, and as you can see, the different sorts of text change throughout the document. I deactivate the preview and everything changes back to Arial. Now I will show you the image-based flat plan. I save this layout and close it. I open the file flatplan dynamic 210 by 280 images. This is again a template file, which means the new document will be an unnamed document. We can easily change that. Save the document as magazine images. And you can see that the document name was updated instantly. Deactivating the preview with the shortcut W, you can see that in this table we have many image frames, and those image frames can be filled with images or even pages from PDFs or other InDesign documents. I would like to insert a magazine with 28 pages at once to show you which trick has to be used to make InDesign place all images at the same time into the table cell frames. I start with File Place and use a file called Layout. The option Static Captioning has to be activated to place all pages one after the next in one run. Usually this step is not necessary if you have separate image frames which are not anchored in a table. Additionally, I activate the import options by holding the Shift key while I click the Open button. This way I can also have a look at the pages, but I will import all pages from 1 to 28. Here are the trim options. I keep those at page bounding box. I press OK and start now to fill up all the frames. First, I place the cover, followed by an ad on the inner cover page. I have to continue below because the next two placeholders belong to the two pages of the back cover. I continue here and place one page after the next into the layout. I fast forward so you don't have to watch me placing all the other pages. Now we arrived at the end and I can finish up with placing the ads on the back cover pages. When you are finished, press the Escape key. I zoom in a bit and we see the layout. The advantage of placing InDesign pages is that if pages get changed in the source document, they will be automatically updated in the flat plan. You can see that as well in the links panel. Let's do that just for demonstration purposes. I open the source file while holding down the Alt key and double-clicking on the image. Let's move the article from pages 8 to 9 two pages backwards. I save the file and switch back to my flat plan. In the background, we can already see how the document is updated. And here the pages are already exchanged. I zoom out again. If you plan a magazine or a different publication with more than 80 pages, 80 pages already set up here, I edit a second page to be populated. I deactivate the preview again. As you can see, the text frame is already threaded to the next page and new pages will flow right into this frame. What you have to do now is to go to the end of your page range. As there is only a single page, I place my cursor, hold down the Shift key and push the right arrow key. The first time to activate the space character and the second time to select the text frame. I delete the selection and with the Shift key pressed, I hit the left arrow key to select the table, including the previous space character. Pressing Command or Control Copy, I copy the selection. Now I move the cursor to the end and paste. And then paste again. This led us automatically onto the second page and I can now add as many pages with additional pasting as desired. Let's assume we have a publication with 128 pages. At the end, if you prefer to see a single page, select the table with your text tool, and pressing Shift-Delete, the table cells will be erased, and also down here you can eliminate the table cells with Shift-Delete. I jump back to the main page and I will show you how you can adjust the pagination if you want to have the page numbers of your magazine reflected by the flat plan. When getting quotes from your printer, the cover and core pages are often shown as separate pages. In our example, we have a cover with 4 pages and a core of 24 pages. That's why I have set the numbering from 1 to 24. If you want to see the pagination from your magazine, in this case this would be page number 3, you can do the following to achieve this. With the mouse button, click into the text box of your pagination. Up in the control panel, you can see that the function numbered list is activated. Click the symbol with the Alt key pressed and the options dialog will pop up. In the mode section, change the number from 1 to 3. Activate the preview and you can see that the page numbers have been adjusted. Confirm with OK and your flat plan pagination matches the pagination in your magazine.